So this is an example problem of using the hydrostatics equation to solve, in this case, for the specific gravity of oil in an open-ended manometer that's open-end on both sides to the atmosphere that has three different fluids in it: oil, water, and air. We have the heights of the columns of each of the fluids. The water is connected from one side to the other. So there are a couple of different ways that we can solve this. One, we could solve by adding up the pressures from point one all the way to the bottom of the manometer and equating that to the pressures from point two all the way to the bottom of the manometer. But a little shortcut that I will apply here is, since we have water as a continuous fluid in the bottom of the manometer, we can draw our dashed line here and just add up from point one down to that dashed line and from point two down to that dashed line. So, on the left-hand side, down to the dashed line, the pressure is P1 plus the density of the oil, G, times its height, plus the density of the air, G, times its height. And that must be equivalent to the pressure at that same vertical level on the right-hand side. So that is P2 plus the density of water times G times H4 minus H3. Notice I'm first writing everything in terms of variables, and only at the end I will plug in the values and the units. Another assumption that is often made in manometer problems is that the densities of gases are much lower than the densities of liquids, and we will make that assumption in this case. And this allows us to neglect the density of air term. Additionally, since both ends are open to the atmosphere, the pressure at point one is equal to the pressure at point two. So this simplifies the equation and allows us to solve for the specific gravity of the oil. The gravity term on each side cancels out, and the specific gravity, being defined as the density divided by the density of water, simply becomes the ratio of H4 minus H3 over H1. Plugging in numbers, we get the result that the specific gravity of the oil is approximately 0.8. It's always good to go back and check the assumptions that were made and understand why the calculation is an estimate. In this case, we made the assumption that the density of air was negligible compared to the densities of the water and the oil, a good assumption. And we also applied the fact that pressure at point one was equal to pressure at point two because both were open to the atmosphere.